In this FlexSim Basics video, we're going to give you a tour of FlexSim and show you where to find the most essential tools and features. When FlexSim starts up, you'll see a blue start page. From here, you can start a new model or open an existing one, view the manual, edit preferences, access licensing, and you can quickly find information on your version of FlexSim, installed licenses and modules, and recently opened models. If you're connected to the internet, you'll also see active content that will connect you to the latest FlexSim videos, tutorials, and other helpful resources. Open an existing model or create a new one to dive into FlexSim. If you're creating a new model, you must first set the model units you will be working with. You can use the defaults if the measurement units aren't important for this particular model, but in most cases, it is important to use the best units for your scenario. Be aware that the time, length, and fluid measurement units cannot be changed after you exit this window, so it's a good idea to determine these before creating your model. Model start time can be easily changed later on. The default FlexSim view is made up of three panes plus the menus and tools above. To the left is the library, which houses the resources, task executors, and other tools that we'll use to create a model. In the center is the model view, which is a view into the 3D world of our simulation model. To start building, simply drag resources from the library and into the model view. This view can be easily manipulated. Left-click and drag to pan the view, right-click and drag to rotate the view, and use the mouse's scroll wheel to zoom in and out. Alternatively, you can click and hold both mouse buttons and drag to zoom. The right pane shows some quick global properties for our model, but if you click to highlight any resource you've dragged into the model, this pane will show properties for that object. The left and right panes are actually both context sensitive, meaning their content will change depending on the situation to make the model building experience simpler. Just above the pane sits the toolbar with its two rows of buttons. The reset, run, stop, and step buttons control the execution of a simulation model, with the runtime dialog controlling how long the simulation runs, and the run speed controlling how quickly it runs. The toolbar also provides easy access to opening, saving, or creating a new model, connecting objects, opening additional model views, the script console, and other utilities. This toolbar can even be customized with quick access to the most useful utilities for your situation. The menu bar is arranged by category and gives access to nearly all of the tools and features FlexSim has to offer. To access FlexSim's user manual, click on Help in the menu bar and then User's Manual. The manual provides thorough documentation of the features and tools in FlexSim, with plenty of images and even videos to quickly explain concepts. If you need information on a button, menu, dialog box, window, or anything else, the quickest answer will most likely come from this manual. Thank you for watching. Be sure to see the rest of the FlexSim Basics series. These short videos will teach you the basics to building a successful simulation model.